meeting up and then next date. Worst date ever.
Worst date ever? Yes, in the history.
Okay, so I once, when I was 19 years old, which was before I was born, I actually met up with this girl, and she was like messaging me a lot, and she was acting like really keen to like, you know, do the jiggy jig. Is that how you call it in the Philippines?
Jiggy jiggy.
Yeah. Anyway, okay. And so basically I met up with her in my mum's car, and I thought I'd drive her around to the nice golf course.
Okay.
Yep. We ended up in a cemetery, which was good. And then I started like, you know, like making out with her and stuff, and then she pulls back and she's like, you're a really bad kisser. Like, oh, thanks. Yeah, my cousin used to tell me that. And then she started instructing me on what to do. Like, oh, you use too much of this, too much of that.
Oh.
And then I kicked her out of my car and left her on the golf course. And so,
oh, my God.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm savage. So what about you, Charlie?
Sort of back up your story. I'll do another story similar to that. So we told this girl about 3 months. Having kissed her, done nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And she lived, like, I think Oatley or something, like sort of an hour past the airport. Anyway, this one night.
It's like in Sydney, it's far.
I'm in Philippines. So it's far away. It's about an hour and a half from my house.
Okay.
And it's one time, she called me up on a Saturday night, probably like 11 o'clock at night. She goes, hey, what are you up to?
Mm.
And she was really drunk. And I was like, oh, I'm just at home. And I've done nothing to this girl. So I've been like waiting for this moment. Like,
you told
like,
me the story, eh?
I told you the story.
Okay.
Only because he brought the story of the girl not liking how he was kissing her. So anyway, so I was like, oh, nothing, I'm just at home. What are you up to? She goes, nothing. Like, do you want me to come over? And I was so shocked. I was like, yeah, okay. It was like thunderstorming. It was raining. It was the worst possible weather in Sydney at the time. So I was like, if you want to, like, why else would she come over?
Okay.
Her mum drove her to my house because she was drunk. So I don't know what, I don't know what story.
Mom,
I swear to God, I don't know what story she gave her mum, but her mum drove her to my house. Got to my house at 1 o'clock. She came over to my house. We're in the bed. She's on her phone swapping through Instagram for 2 hours straight, not even talking to me. I'm just like, what the fuck is going on? And then anyway, I just sort of like, fuck this. Reached in, just grabbed her, and I started kissing her. And then after that, I got my fingers and put them down where they're supposed to go.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And she goes to me, yeah, I don't really like this. And I was like, what do you mean? She's like, my ex-boyfriend doesn't finger me like this. He didn't finger me like this. And I was like, what are you talking about? And
she goes, how many fingers did you use?
She's two.
I usually use a whole fist. So
and then she goes to me, before the fingering, she was like, do you have a condom? I'm like, yeah, I got a condom. She's like, oh, perfect. Start fingering her, and she goes, that's not how my ex used to finger me. And I was like, what the fuck? And then she goes to me, actually, I don't have sex anymore. Maybe we just talk and just call it a night. And my eyes lit up. And for a guy, when you tell that guy you're about to have sex with him, and you don't,
yeah,
I didn't use that.
Yeah.
So when you tell a guy that you want to have sex with him, but you end up not doing it, that's the worst possible thing because the guy gets blue balls and it's the worst thing. So I lit up in flames and I said, "Get the fuck out of my house!" And I literally just threw out my house.
Yeah.
And it was pissing down rain. There was lightning. I don't know how she got home. It was like 3 a.m.
Like,
and then I never spoke to her again. That was it.
Oh, I was about to ask that question. Like, so is it safe to say that?
Sorry, go on.
No,
just to back up Charlie, not with another story, but with a guy, if a girl leads you on that much, obviously you have to be respectful and, you know, if she doesn't want it, that's fine. But if you lead on a guy that much and then she like just doesn't do anything, it's worse than like, say, for example, like the feeling's worse than say having your friend die. So if Charlie died, it'd be like a better feeling than if she rejected me.
Just
so
me.
I'd rather him like, you know, do that than me.
It was just worse because we've been talking 3 months, been on like 6 dates, haven't kissed, done nothing, and then this time was like, yes, okay, we're sweet. She tells me we're gonna do it, and then she pulls out last minute. And yeah, and also because my sister was sleeping in the other room, I had to tiptoe past her, and she's really like private and like, and so I had to sneak her in, and I just screamed like, get the hell out, which is probably not the best thing, but pissing down rain, lightning, so I don't know how she got home.
So I think the lesson that we derive from this story, from the stories of these fine gentlemen, are do not lead a guy on.
Yes.
I think
that
applies also to men. So do not lead girls on. So
I
right.
Guys always lead him on.